Good morning, you guys. So today I've been really wanting to do this video, and today I thought that I would bring you guys along my day as a stay-at-home teacher. It's so weird to say that, and it's just like I wanted to do it the past couple days that we've started e-learning, but I was just trying to get situated and prepared, and it's just been very different, but I'm trying to stay positive through it all, especially for my students. I'm wearing my Teacher Life shirt because this is clearly Teacher Life at its finest, apparently, right now. So right now I woke up and e-learning starts at 8:30. It's like 8:40 right now, and I was gonna log on, but then my sugars are low. So I went and got a juice pouch because I have diabetes, so grabbed a juice pouch and I'm just kind of waiting for them to go back up. But I made some oatmeal and some coffee, and then I'm gonna go ahead and email my kids saying don't forget that we are doing a Google Meets, which is like how I'm gonna do tutoring and stuff, at what time? 11. So I'm gonna let them know about that. And I'm also gonna post a Google question because our platform is like Google Classroom, and just ask them how they're doing. I kind of want to post a Google question every day. Day two, I posted like, how are you feeling about this stuff? How are you feeling about being home? And it was interesting to see their responses. Some of them were good, some of them were like, I miss being at school. So that is the plan for right now. Got my oatmeal and my coffee ready to go. Actually, not really, because I need some creamer. So I'm sitting at my little desk area. Our office space is kind of like where we throw furniture and stuff that we're not using at the moment, but also I kind of set up my desk area to be kind of open so it doesn't look entirely like junky, I guess. So let me show you guys, if I can open my computer correctly, how I am teaching the students, especially math. We started with adding, subtracting, multiplying fractions because that's just what students need help with, is fractions. Like, just to be completely honest, so we were like, let's review fractions with them. And so the other day I had a student ask me for help, and I got on Google Meet, shared my desktop, and I got to write everything out, and I'm gonna show you guys how I did that in just 1 second. This is boredom at its finest. Yesterday I was on Amazon and I was looking up like gel kits because I want to do my nails, and I'm like contemplating buying one. I'm gonna shoot an email to all my students. So basically what I said was, hey y'all, Google Meets today at 11 a.m. I hope to see a lot of you guys join. Bring your questions, comments, concerns, or even just yourself. Link will be posted on Google Classroom. Hope to see you then. So really simple, but just to send them that email to let them know that I'm doing it. Last time I did it, which was last week, I had like 30 students on there. It was really great. Like, I loved seeing them. And there were a couple questions, and then after that, we had like a pet show and tell. So on Google Classroom, I said that I was gonna post a question every day, and this is what I'm posting today. Just thinking of y'all, how are you doing? I just wanna be here for them. So I'm gonna ask my kiddos, I'm going to ask them that question. I don't think I said this, but I teach 7th grade math. I'm a first year teacher, and it has been a roller coaster, but in the best way possible. Like, I love roller coasters, so it's all good, but you know, it's been, I have my ups and my downs, but all together it has been amazing just getting to be a teacher and getting to learn about these kids. I love them, I really do, and I really, really miss them. And this is not like a vacation for me whatsoever, and I know it isn't for most teachers. This is like really hard for me to be home and not get to see my kids, so I look forward to those meetings and those tutoring sessions, and I hope to see a bunch of kids there just so I can see their faces. So that's my spiel on all that, but I was gonna show you guys how I teach and kind of like how the PowerPoints roll right now for online learning. So basically what happened was the district gave everyone in the district a template for how they were giving their lessons because they wanted the students to have something that was constant throughout and not a bunch of different platforms. So everyone has like this day one, day two, day three PowerPoint. So this was day one. It was on the 18th. It started last Wednesday. And basically what's happening here is I put a launch here, and this launch, I only have one launch in this whole 10 days. So this launch was just like a little activity to get their brains thinking, and the lesson and the practice was basically what they were doing. So day one was on adding fractions. They click this link, and it takes them to Khan Academy YouTube video. Of course, it's not going to load right now, but anyways, that's where that would take you to. And then the practice takes you to a worksheet, which, oh, okay, I was going to say, is that not loading? And it's so funny because when I put this on there, I didn't realize that 2 through 4 are the same and then 1 and 6 are the same. I don't understand that, but anyways, okay, so I had a student email me and say, can you help me? So we did a Google Meets, and then from Google Meets, I shared my screen and I went to the screen here, and I'm going to show you guys how on earth I wrote to show him, and I used this little guy. So this is called an active slate. It pairs with my Promethean board at school, but it also pairs with my computer. So I take this little USB and I plug it in, and you're gonna hear that little sound, and then I just press the little button on the back, if I can find it. I press the button, and then you'll see this little guy say registered, and then that means that it's on, and now that means that it's connected to my computer. So as you can see, I'm moving the mouse on this little guy here, but it's moving on the computer. So basically, there's this little, let me just use my mouse because it's quicker, but I can click this little drop down arrow and choose the pen and choose like whatever color I want. Let's say I want pink. I can close it, and now I can take my active slate and write on here. So this is 2/4 + 1/2. And then I can explain to them, well, you need a common denominator. So what they both share is 4. So you could keep this 4 here, and then like talk about how did you get that and stuff like that. So this was really, I'm really glad that I brought this home, because if not, I would have been able to do it, but I would have had to write it with my mouse, and I'm just not as good at it as I am with the pen.
Hello. Hi, my love. What you doing? Good morning.
She's actually been sleeping in a lot. Like, she's usually up super early, and I think her body's getting used to just me being here so she can sleep as late as she wants. So I was gonna actually make my bed, but I think I'm gonna wash the sheets and everything, just because, you know, with everything going on, I just think I should wash this. The least that I could do was make my bed since I'm home, and I feel like I'm gonna feel better that my bed is made. I'm washing some sheets and some pillowcases right now. I mentioned this in my apartment tour, but my grandma actually made this piece and this quilt, and she quilted this for our wedding, and it's just super duper sweet. I love it. But yeah, I'm starting to feel a little bit better. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to do my makeup while sitting at my desk, and then just see if anyone's going to reach out to me before I start video chatting.
I had to do something about my hair. I just feel like if I look more presentable, I'll feel like I'm more at work. Like, I feel like I'm working, but I don't know if that makes sense or not. So I have my handy dandy mirror with me, and I'm going to do some light makeup to try to look a little more presentable.
And leave me a comment down below. Who are you guys following on social right now that really inspires you to get something done, maybe try something?
I feel 100 times better. I don't know why. That sounds really bad. And like, I don't feel like I need makeup, but I feel like just more presentable. I don't know what's going on here. So yeah, I was just sitting at my desk watching some YouTube, doing my makeup, and in about 25 minutes is when we're doing the Zoom. Not the Zoom, sorry. My mind just went blank. the Google Meets. So it's really easy to work too if you've never worked it. Super easy. You just give your kids the link and they click the link and then they click join video and then there it is. Okay, so right now I've just been kind of going through some emails, emailing some students that emailed me some questions. And then, so I'm sure that some people might have questions on this. So we are a one-to-one school, so all of our students have computers, but of course there are some that don't have internet, or they might have just wanted the packet that we put together that is completely just pick up the packet and all that you need is right there, so you don't have to access the computer. So we were trying to figure out like who picked up the packet and who is not logging in so we can like make contact. I'm using my phone here, but this is where we are going to meet up with all the students. So it's just Google Meets, and then they'll just click that join now button to join the video. And I'm about to copy and paste the link for them to join, and I'm gonna post it in Google Classroom, and then we'll meet up here. I hope I have a good amount of students. I'm moving because we're having a pet show and tell, because I just went over everything, any questions they had. So now we're showing each other their pets. But yeah, I miss you guys. Hopefully this will pass quick. Well, I just met with my Math 7 kiddos, and now I'm going to meet with my pre-AP or like honors kids. They're supposed to meet in a couple minutes, so we'll see how many join. We had a really good turnout for Math 7 though, so that was awesome. It's 12, and I'm going to make some egg salad. So I'm going to boil some eggs. My husband's home. He's eating lunch, and I'm gonna wait for these eggs to boil. My students gave us some farm eggs. How sweet! So I'm gonna boil some. I ended up making the noodles because it just sounded so good. So now here I am, just working on some stuff. Got my noodles, and I also eat them by themselves. Like, am I gonna get, I feel like that might be weird because there's no pasta sauce on it, but it already has cheese inside, and it's delicious with just like some salt. So good, y'all. So good.
It's not the nicest day out, but it's like 2 o'clock now, and I'm taking this one out to go to the bathroom. She basically takes me for a walk. Seriously, I need to work on her not pulling.
So it is 7:45, and I was gonna cook, but then I got lazy, so we're ordering Bite Squad. A sandwich place called Groucho's. We are excited.